Welcome to Just Wing It, STBC Star Trek Day Special. Today, we go up against all hero ships with the Enterprise E. This is my second attempt. I had originally tried it and it crashed, but I think I might be able to get it to work. This time, I'm going to add the ships individually and see how we do. The version of the Enterprise is what we see in Armada 3. I chose that ship because it's more likely the only ship that can actually take on all of the hero ships. So let's go canonical. In X-Class first. Let's get going. Somehow I don't think this is even going to be a challenge. In this case, I'm not going to use torpedoes, only phasers.
Red alert, shields up.
And I will not be boosting any of the systems. Single fire mode only.
Sir, we are draining their top shield. Is draining.
I personally love the model of this ship.
Integrity at 50%.
Sorry, Captain Archer. Maybe I should boost my senses.
Target hull integrity at 25%. Target hull integrity at 20%. Target's hull has been breached, Captain.
Okay, they're dead. All crew members dead. Let's finish it off.
That's it. We got him.
As predicted, that was just too easy.
Captain?
All right. Let's go after Captain Pike's Enterprise. If I remember where it is now. There it is. I don't think there's going to be much difference. Only photon torpedoes and phasers for this one.
Intercept course plotted.
Forward shield is draining.
I'm gonna use manual targeting.
Their bottom shield is draining, sir.
Shields are holding.
Sir, the right shield has failed. Sir, the right shield has failed.
That looks painful. Ooh, that looked painful. Whoops. Completely destroyed. Lucky shot. Right, Captain Kirk's Enterprise from TOS.
Your orders, Captain?
I forgot where it is now. I think let me do the tier S error first, and then I shall do the Kelvin timeline.
Your orders, sir?
Your orders, sir. Initiating scan. I'm not reading anything new, Captain.
What? Okay, this is the refit model. Oh well. I've been very lenient. You'll take us a saucer. Way too easy.
Your orders, sir?
Alright, let's do what I was actually originally planning on doing. That's assuming I can figure out which one it was now. I think it was the Baz 1701 chips. But one of them has an error and uses the Enterprise E for some reason. I think it was the TMP error over here that used the Enterprise E, so it should be fine. Yep, that's the correct one. I don't imagine this one being any threat. Ah, the classic Connie. I'm gonna go to manual targeting again.
Their bottom shield is draining, sir. Sir, we are draining their top shield. Their forward shield is draining.
Wow, it actually is doing some damage. Not for long, I imagine. Ooh, that hurt.
Target hull integrity at 25%.
Thank you.
is severely damaged, sir.
All done. Okay, since we already did the TMP error Enterprise, let's go on to Enterprise B.
Captain?
Excelsior class, where are you? There it is. Still only gonna use phases and photons. No boosting besides sensors.
Intercept course plotted.
Shield is draining. Captain, our attacks are draining their right shield.
I'm actually almost out of photons. Well, I guess using phasers will make this a bit more fair.
Target hull integrity at 75%. Sir, we are draining their top shield. Thank you. integrity at 50%.
Actually quite a tough ship. That ship landing.
Sir, their aft shield is draining.
Without their sensors, they cannot fire him. But unfair of me to do that to them. But I don't have torpedoes. Well, I do. Quantums. But that's just too easy.
Target hull integrity at 25%.
In fact, I think the ship does have other torpedoes as well.
Changing torpedo.
Ooh, class X. Okay, lucky shot it is. Alright, let's stick to the Class X torpedoes and go on against the Enterprise C.
Yes, Captain.
Ambassador class. Definitely not the damaged one. Let's use the torpedo variant. Oops, I forgot to add it.
Intercept course plotted.
Again, going for the sensor array. No quantum torpedoes yet. He hasn't fired back. Why? Oh, okay.
Sir, we are draining their top shield.
Oh, that must have hurt.
Target hull integrity at 75%.
That's gonna hurt. I don't know, maybe the Class X are a little bit too powerful.
Target hull integrity at 50%. Shield is draining.
that's gonna hurt.
Target hull integrity at 25%.
Let's finish them off.
Their hull is severely damaged, sir.
So Voyager was actually armed with Class X torpedoes. Always thought that was interesting. It's never really mentioned, but it is actually visually seen on one of the Alcars menus. Okay, let's go for the Enterprise D. I'm actually gonna completely reset, so bear with me. This time, I am going to use quantum torpedoes. And this is the Enterprise as seen in Generations. So it's the most powerful we see it. Despite it being destroyed by a bird of prey.
Red alert, shields up.
This Enterprise has the Class X. Quite a big difference.
Integrity at 50%. The forward shield is draining.
With the quantums, I can't get too close, otherwise the quantums will damage me as well.
The bottom shield is draining, sir. At 25%. Sir, they have hull breaches on multiple decks. Their hull is
the Enterprise D was surprisingly powerful. Alright, let's go for the JJ Abrams Enterprise. Should have actually done that before the Enterprise B, but I completely forgot. Okay, back to only phases and photons.
Red alert, shields up.
Intercept course plotted.
top shield has failed.
Oops. Okay, I don't expect that.
That's it. We got him.
Alright, let's go for Defiant. Defiant, I will have to go all out on again. This is the second Defiant as seen in the final season of DS9.
Red alert, shields up.
We are draining their top shield.
There we go, the Defiant has been destroyed. It wasn't actually as tough as I thought it would be. Alright, next up is Voyager. If Voyager uses its tri-cobalts, I'm screwed. This could be fun. I'm supposed to have point defense on this ship, but I can't figure out why I can't use it.
Red alert, shields up.
Going all out. Doesn't look like Voyager is using its tri-cobalts. That's disappointing. In that case, I'll limit my quantums.
Shield is draining, sir.
Oh, those torpedoes are accurate.
Sir, we are draining their top shield.
Voyager is tough.
Our ventral shields are draining, sir. shields are draining, sir.
Finishing him. Yeah, can't mess with quantum torpedoes.
That's it. We got him.
Okay, so as a bonus, I am also gonna do Prometheus. Unfortunately, I don't have a working Galaxy Dreadnought. For some reason, I've never got them to work. I will not go up against the Enterprise J. That's just not gonna work. If you have any other battle requests, please feel free to let me know.
Red alert, shields up.
Captain, we have collapsed your bottom shield.
The Prometheus isn't as powerful as people think it is. Fans seem to think that it's going to be more powerful than the Enterprise.
Their top shield has failed.
But you can already see it's no match for the Enterprise. Oh wow, okay. That was interesting. I wonder why they didn't use the multivectoral assault mode on that one. Alright, so let me do one more bonus, just for the fun of it. Let's use the Enterprise as seen in Nemesis, and then also as seen in First Contact against Prometheus. First contact one. Should be a bit more of a challenge. Quite a difference in maneuverability.
Shield has failed, Captain. Their sensor system has been disabled.
Bit of hull damage there.
Disabled, Captain.
got him. Once you hit that warp core, it's game over. Final battle for today. Now I've got to remember where I put the normal Nemesis model. Ah, there you are. Okay, cool. This shouldn't take too long.
Red alert, shields up.
I love the sound of the quantums on this one. The entire model is fantastic. That's all for today. Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, click on notifications and share. Also feel free to comment below. Thank you for watching and happy Star Trek Day. Live long and prosper.